Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I thought I'd get the first adventure of 2020 out of the way, do a solo one night camp. I am struggling, to be honest. As you can see, it's just full of hills, each side rocks, and a stream about 3 miles ahead goes into Ogden Reservoir. But I'll keep going, guys, and hopefully I can find a suitable flat surface and improvise and try get me tent pitched up. Obviously let it get a bit more dark. It is overcast and it is due to rain all night. Yeah, and the weather is it's not good. It won't be good later on, but I think the wind's 25 mile an hour tops. It should settle down later on, so it'll be interesting how the Vango will cope, especially when I get a bit higher for these winds. And it has got a TBS tension band, so I'd like to try that out to see how that copes. I know it's not very extreme winds, but we'll see what happens, guys. It's about a 4 mile walk. These are easier route, which is just itself around Ogden Reservoir, and then further up past it I'm heading really well deep past it.
Mike India Zero, Tango Golf Oscar, listening on 335.
About 2-3 miles.
MI Zero, TGO, listening on
335. Which is about 4 mile walk all the way around. I'm just east of Halifax, edge of Bradford, towards Mixenden and all them sort of ways up on Ovenden Moor. There's quite a lot of reservoirs around here. I think it's about 7 or 8. But problem is, it's like a nature reserve, I guess. A lot of walkers and stuff like that, so got to be careful really. But yeah, like I said, I'm gonna try get deep into it, and hopefully I won't be disturbed. Right, top of this hill, I'll be camping. It's the only, believe it or not, it's the only flat bit I can find. It's all moorland. There's a wind farm up there. And yeah, the waterfall is here. Now, a lot of people say, oh, don't camp next to a waterfall, you can't hear people coming. And then there's other people that say it's relaxing on a night and it helps you to sleep. So either one with me, I don't mind. What will happen will happen. But you've got more chance of something happening in an urban area than up in Stips here. There is something in the water there. I'm going to go show you in a minute. Someone said it's something to do with the Bronte sisters, like one of them statue things that are scattered all over the Bronte county. But someone said it's a valve, so I'll show you it and see what you think. Leave me a comment. So to get to the waterfall, it is thick, dense with these brambles. And the little valve thing, there, which I don't know if that's like rust what's coming from it. Yeah, it's a weird little thing.
Ooh,
Got the Osprey Kestrel 48 litre backpack. Perfect for a one nighter. Got the OAX compact 3/4 length self-inflating mat, which I'll be doing a review on another time. And also I'm using the Banshee Pro 200. If you look down on my channel, further down on my channel, there's an overview of that tent. Right, I think it's time to set up. As you can see, guys, the Banshee's all set up. I didn't show you that because, like I said, I've showed you the overview and setup in previous video. It is a little bit windy, highs of 25 miles an hour winds, and as expected, it is rocky ground, so it was a struggle getting the tent pegs in. Banshee has got two doors, entrances, one there. So I've got one facing the waterfall. And obviously one on the other side, which is facing an hill. But on top of that hill is the moors. Right, first up, we've got the OAX compact 3/4 length self-inflating mat. Next is my sleeping bag, which is a genuine British Army, and believe me, this one is warm, but it is absolutely massive. When it came out of the Army, it didn't come with the compression straps. I had to buy that separately, and yeah, this bag takes up half of my Osprey bag, so it is a big chunk. That's a British sleeping bag on top of the OEX compact. Some people put the self-inflating mat inside, but no, I think that's really uncomfortable, and yeah, I like it sitting on top. Might slide around a bit, but no, I don't like it inside. I did forget me genuine British Army sleeping liner. I've left that at home, which I'm not happy about, so I've got to make do with that. I think it's going to be low as 5 tonight, so that's well capable of that. Next is the Vango self-inflating pillar, which again I've done a little review on this. Okay, that's all in now. As you can see, it's windy. I have chose the waterfall door, as on this side, on the hillside, it's windy, so that door there is not getting opened, that is stopping the wind. It has started to rain now, so I'll get settled in my tent and do a little bit of cooking. 48 litre Osprey Kestrel easily fits in the vestibule of the Vango Banshee. I did bring the Vango tarp, but with this wind, I think it'll just flap about and it won't be worth it, to be honest. So here's a 360, guys. You'd think I'd be blocked in from the elements of the wind with me being in sweeping. I think what's happening is sweeping through that valley there, and it's coming across all across here and sweeping down. into my tent. So, and it has started to rain, so I'm not happy about the tarp. But like I said, you got to take the rough with the smooth. I have improvised though. I've used my walking stick as a bit of a shelter. The wind is really picking up now, which I thought had died down, to be honest. He said it was gonna. But yeah, I can actually cook under there now. So let's get some food on. On the menu today, we've got the pork sausage and beans in tomato sauce, exclusively from the British Army. Now, it doesn't state how long it is, but going off the other food, what I've cooked, I'd give it 6 minutes in there. We've got the Coleman cook set. Got a Pfizer ignition, wind block. I'll just show you it underneath. From go outdoors around about 60 quid. Only thing I don't like about this so far, it didn't come with a bag to put it all in. Literally, that's all you get. You do actually get an handle, but you won't be carrying that around, will you? You put it in your bag. So they like for it to come with a dry bag. You've got your silicone lid on top with the Coleman logo. So guys, we've got the pork sausage and beans and tomato sauce from the British Army. Beans. Wow, get the wind. Yeah, not really. You can't really review beans and sausage, can you? I mean, only thing you can say is, yeah, the beans are, the sauce is nice and thick. I don't know if you'll get to see that. And the sausages are them, you know them, like the hot dog sausages, not like proper sausages. But it's warm, it's light food, and I'm hungry. I'll bring you back after. Right guys, it's nice and dark out there. All my tent's red. I like using red lights because I think it's more discreet than white. Do you think the same? Let us know in the comments. That sausage and beans were really nice. I've just had a cup of coffee. Just gonna chill out a little bit now. I have got internet. That's a good thing of not camping up in like the Yorkshire Dales or Peak District. I do have a bit of signal and a bit of internet, so that'll pass a few hours by. Because as you know, it's early night and you are more or less tent bound, and it is raining as well. And that's another thing why I like Vango tents, because I can sit up. I had a, if you look at the top of my channel, there's a picture of my OEX Fox in the snow, and I was tent bound for around 6 hours, and all you could do in the OEX was lay down basically. I'm gonna turn this on white, see, because I'm looking all red. But yeah, so basically that's a good thing about the Banshee. I can sit up, because after a while laying down, it does your back in. So, and also, like, I can get unchanged. In the OX Fox 1, I had to have my legs half out of the tent, and yeah, it's no good. And also, it were inner pitch first. And even though I never camped in rain, it did snow. So the Banshee's all round better tent. I'm not knocking the OAX Fox. It's a great little stealth camping tent. It is what it is. It's solid, sturdy, and for a quick, what it is with that, you just, when, once you lay down, you go to sleep, basically. The Banshee is a much better tent. Dual door, out of 10 pitch first. It's like got a little, you can see there, but it's got like a little window mesh ring, so you can put your dirty boots down there. So that goes to outside. And only thing, like on my overview on a few videos down, like I am now, pretty much tent bound because it's raining, high winds and dark. This mesh door, so that's outside now. This mesh door you got to leave open. Like I said to Vango, they should have the door where you can see through it. At least it's closed. But hopefully in the future, like I said on that review, they'll change that. But anyway, we'll see how it goes. I'm alright, and turn this light out because I don't really like using white light when I'm in the tent. It's more discreet, as you noticed, with the red light on. So what I'll do, if anything happens or like that, I'll bring you back. Other than that, it's good night from me, and I'll see you in the morning. Yeah, it can't stop raining. It's been raining for I'd say about 5 hours or something now, and I think I picked a bad spot, to be honest. Well, it was the only spot really what's flat. But it tank come through tent underneath. The Banshee is a 6,000 hydrostatic head. But later on, after a few more hours, we'll see if it comes through. So it's a bit of a test really for the Banshee. It is a bathtub design as well, so I'll keep you updated on that. Yeah, lamping around field, just seen a fox looking at me somewhere up there. Trying to exercise out, and back at the woodland over there, a deer. Yeah, this torch, the red LED Cree, is excellent torch. On the edge of the moorland. But yeah, this LED Cree flashlight goes pretty far. Right guys, this is the hillside door, if you remember. Other side is where the big puddles are gathering, and it's been raining literally 9 hours non-stop, pretty heavy-ish as well, and so far so good. The ground sheet's holding up, and I can even feel the water sludging on underneath. And yeah, so far so good. What I'll do, I'll bring you back and go take a look outside to see how deep it's got. We've got 12 hours of rain non-stop. And it is absolutely soaking the ground. I haven't got a footprint as well, so I'll show you inside now for the final time and see if it's come through the ground sheet. It has been raining for 12 hours constantly, but that's the only thing, a few little speckles there really. Like I said, I haven't got a footprint, and the ground sheet has been sitting on it, the puddle of water out there. But all the other bit of the tent is all dry, so the Banshee's done really well. I think if I got a footprint, I think that I'd stop that. But anyway, it's 3 o'clock in the morning, and I'm going to try to get some more hours sleep, so I'll bring you back tomorrow. Right guys, it's next morning. I've already begun to pack my sleeping bag, myself inflating marks. Everything's packed up really, and packed away except for the tent. It is still raining outside, so I bet that's like 16 hour, 17 hour rain non-stop. So I've got to put the Banshee down in the rain, and then once I've done that, it's heading home. So I'll catch you in a bit. As always guys, leave no trace. That's me packed up and ready to go. Hope you like that video guys. Time to get home and have a hot bath. First trip of 2020, first trip of many. Cheers for watching, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.